The previous video that I uploaded on the channel prior to this video was about the new anniversary event, so the 10th year anniversary. They're actually making a ship, and most of you guys have commented like this ship actually has a kit bash kind of like components in the Klingons and also the Federation, so basically like a mix of them together. And if you haven't seen that video, there is a link in the description to that video. There's also a screenshot where you guys can actually see that particular ship, and also the statistics of that ship is available on the Tribble testing server right now, right available right here. And it's called the Khitomer Alliance Battlecruiser. Now, like I said, the majority of you guys are like, hey, this is a kit bash of Klingons and Federation design into one. So today I started up my STO launcher and there was a text saying like, hey, there is a new joint operation thing going to be available for us soon. And let me just bring that page up right now so we can read about that. So it is, as it is stated right here, the Khitomer Alliance launches a new joint service. This has just been, you know, released as a blog post, obviously, from Cryptic's own website right here. And there is, you can actually see a starbase of Klingon design and a Federation ship, and some kind of like nebula and like, you know, pieces of, you know, asteroid or debris, whatever that is. But we are actually more interested in this, what they have written right here for us. So the Khitomer Alliance announces a new combined service. Today, the Secretary of the Federation Starfleet and the Grand Dahar Master of the Klingon Imperial Fleet and the Admiral of the Romulan Republic Fleet jointly announced the formation of a new Allied Fleet Service. Could be a new STF, right? TFO, Q, that we might be playing with. This combined service formalizes the strides made in cross-naval cooperate since the end of the Iconian War. As imposing dreams just years off, the ASF, the Allied Fleet Service, in short AFS, hopes to harness the best personnel and technology from all corners to the Khitomer Alliance and build an organized dedicated to the mutual defense of his member status. Building the new Navy from a combined as such diverse culture tradition has been a complex challenge for the admiralties of each nation, but the variety of exchange program, inner fleet exercises and external challenges has motivated of a level incorporated unprecedented in a galactic history. Still, a variety of details remain in flux, such as the final uniform designed, promotion structure, and even dietary and fitness standards. So they're basically saying like, this is going to be a joint operation with Federation Klingons, including the Romulans as well. Now, in the anniversary ship that we are going to get in 2020, in a couple of in like maybe a month or so, something like that, we did see, like I said previous in this recording, Klingon design and also Federation design. And the majority of comments that have been in that video from you guys actually stated the same deal: Klingons and Federation. But there were also a lot of you were like, hey, what happened to the Romulans? Why isn't there a Romulan design in that thing? So maybe this is going to shed a little bit of light in that question. The AFS has opened its doors to members of Starfleet, Klingon Defense Force, and the Romulan Republic Navy. Officers who enlist who volunteer for service in the AFS will change their rank in their original service and continue to acquire seniority in both the AFS and the Navy of their parent nation. Of particular interest to this new adventure in the inclusion of Dominion soldiers and support staff within the AFS. In the wake of the recent Hurk incursion, the Alliance has welcomed the help of the Jemadar soldiers, support staff, and captain in their peacekeeping efforts in the Alpha and Beta Quadrant, as well as sending Alliance support staff to ships in the Gamma Quadrant to aid in the rebuilding efforts there. Thanks to this unprecedented cooperation, it has announced today that the AFS would accept officers applicants from the Dominion, and that the two parties will work closely together to share technologies and tactics. So basically one big happy family. Man, this is interesting. I have no idea what they're actually hinting. This is going to be some kind of joint effort. So Klingon Federation, Romulans, the Dominion over here with the Jemadar and all that. I'm interested. I'm very excited about this. I'm very interested in whatever this is going to be. Maybe like new Q or something like that, and TFO or anything like that. Or who knows, right? Who knows? This is definitely getting my attention and making me excited about this. So the new Admiralty Board for the SF is also being stood up for high level of presentations from the Allied member services. Initially, the SF will only have three flag officers, one of each president member, but that number is expected to grow as ships are added to the AFS Order of Battle. So, I don't know if this is going to be like something like the Admiralty, because that could be, you know, that is something that we already have in the, you know, in the game already. So, I hope not. I hope it's not going to be like one of those duty officer systems or Admiralty system, or in this case AFS systems. But I really hope this is something that we can actually play with. That'd be interesting to accomplish. But anyway, reading on, while Starfleet and the Republic Navy and the Klingon Defense Force have earmarked several hulls to begin building the first ASF squadron, the ASS intends to field bespoke technology and starship designed to accommodate this unique mission and mix of crew. The first of these ships is undergoing space trials now and will be commissioned into the next year in the AFS early next year. This project developed entirely by the Allied Cooperative Starship Development Board to new ship and new crew hopes to mark the beginning of a brand new era, peace to the galactic weary of war. For the galactic weary of war. I'm really, really interested about this. I hope it's going to be something that we are going to be able to play, and not going to be just some kind of like Admiralty mission that we just, you know, start off and then basically forget and then just reap the rewards. But it is hinting us towards like the unofficial screenshot that we actually saw, because that one has been data mined, not by me, unfortunately. I'm just, when it comes to, you know, files and Cryptic and all of that, you know, what Cryptic has done on the background, I'm just basically using the Braille method. I don't know if you guys know that, but the Braille method is just, you know, feel it out, change one to a zero, and then see if it works, and if it doesn't, turn it back into a, you know, to a zero or whatever state it was before it actually did that. But some people out there actually managed to get a screenshot out of there, and that ship basically looks like the aft section is Klingon and the forward section is Federation, and no idea where the Romulans are going to be involved in that, but it kind of looks very nice, to say the least. And with this, they're basically having my attention with, you know, some kind of joint operation that they're going to get going, and they're basically are motivating us to like, hey, this is coming, be informed, because it's going to come maybe, what did it say, earlier this year or something like that. We'll be commissioned into the SF early next year. So they're basically It's in the works. It's in the works. Anyway, this is just a little bit of a, you know, blog post reading, if you can call it that. And I'm very excited about it. So thank you so much to Ambassador Kel for getting us hyped for this thing. Anyway, later.